Hey guys, what's going on? My name is Luke and welcome to my YouTube channel. We're going to take a look at buying in personal names versus buying in trust structures in today's video. I'm going to give you a rundown on the different types of trust structures. We're going to take a little look at land tax and how you can be effective with trust structures. And I'm going to explain what Emily and I have done in our current portfolio and what we're planning to do down the track between personal names and trust structures for our property investing portfolio. Before I jump into more detail in this video, just wanted to say that this isn't financial advice. Please seek a financial advisor that is trusted before taking any actions. And this is just a general chat about trust structures versus personal names. So I'll leave it at that. So there are three types of trust structures. There's a discretionary trust, a unit trust, and a hybrid trust. Now, discretionary trusts are the most popular and the most common, and they do exactly as the name suggests, which is allow the appointers to distribute the funds of the trust to beneficiaries at will each financial year. Unit trusts are based on units within the trust and distributions based on the units held, and a hybrid trust is a mix of the two. For the purposes of this video, we're not going to talk about unit trusts or hybrid trusts any further. We're just going to refer to discretionary trusts because they are the most common and typically the most effective for tax minimization and asset protection. So let's compare buying in personal names versus buying through a trust structure with a corporate trustee. Now, when you buy a property in your personal name, it can be pretty simple and easy to get a loan. You also pay tax based on your marginal tax rates. So you can split the ownership with your partner or with someone else that you go into the deal. And that means that you'll split the income and pay tax at your marginal rate each year based on the income. You also get capital gains tax exemptions in your personal name, which are easy to achieve when you sell a property. And you also get the capital gains tax exemptions when you sell your own home. Now, trust structures are very similar. They're just a flow-through entity. So that means you can also have the income distribution through a trust structure, and you can also flow on capital gains tax minimization strategies through trusts. So in actual fact, buying in personal names and buying in trust structures are very similar. Now, there are three key components when comparing buying in personal names to buying in trusts. That is asset protection, tax minimization, and the legacy of your portfolio. So asset protection, you can potentially receive more asset protection by buying through a trust structure with a corporate trustee. Now on screen here, I'm gonna show you a graphic that shows a basic trust structure with a corporate trustee and the layout of that structure for buying a property. So you can see here that there is a trust which has a corporate trustee, and there is an appointer and primary beneficiaries within the trust. So if you're a husband and wife, you'll be appointer one and appointer two. And then you would also make yourselves the primary beneficiaries of that trust, being beneficiary one and beneficiary two. Now, to give yourself a layer of protection and to not be the trustee in your personal name, many advisors will talk about a corporate trustee. And that is just a corporate entity above the trust. So that would make you the director, so you're the husband and wife, director one and director two, and the major shareholders of that corporation, likely to be a 50-50 split between a husband and a wife. This structure gives you protection by having a corporation between you and the property that you own. It also allows you to have tax minimization by being able to distribute the funds between family beneficiaries for tax purposes. So if one person earned $50,000 a year and another person didn't earn any money during the year, and you had 50% and you were both dual appointers, dual beneficiaries, and the directors of the company, you can make at your discretion and transfer profits from your investment property to the person that had $0 to keep them under the tax threshold and be tax effective. So that's a basic overview of how you potentially buy a property in a trust structure with a corporate trustee. Doing it this way gives you potentially more asset protection by having a corporation as the trustee for the trust, which will reduce the chance that you can be sued. Whereas holding properties in your personal name potentially puts you at a higher risk of getting sued in your personal name and losing those assets. The next one is the tax minimization, as I discussed, where you can be potentially more tax effective through a trust structure by choosing who receives the income from your property. And under personal names, you might not be as tax effective because you have to split the property's profits or losses based on the percentage ownership in the property. Finally, there's the legacy component. So legacy means passing on the properties to another family member or a child, for example. In a trust structure, you can change the directors of the corporate trustee and potentially pass your wealth onto your children without causing a capital gains event. But in personal names, you have to change the title of who owns the property and therefore will trigger a capital gains tax event, and you'll have to pay money to the government for handing over that asset to your child or to another beneficiary. Now, there are some negatives with trusts. Now, let's run through those. You have potentially startup costs of $2,000. You have annual tax statements that will need to be lodged with your trust structure and your corporate trustee, which can be roughly $1,000 per year. You're also gonna have losses, which will be housed in the trust if your property investment doesn't make positive cash flow. And you also create complexity. So it's almost easier sometimes to be simple in your property portfolio building and to not add this complexity until you need it. You also have lower land tax thresholds in some states, with New South Wales and Victoria having $0 as a land tax threshold for trust structures, whereas in personal names, you can have higher land tax thresholds when you buy property in your personal name. So there is a lot to consider, and it's hard to explain this all in a short video. So I'm sure I'm going to bring out more videos on trust structures and discussing our approach to managing our property investment portfolio as we go forward. You need to weigh up all the factors that I've discussed in this video. And like I said, have a chat to a financial advisor or a trusted individual about your situation. If you could leave a comment down below on this video, if you've got any questions, drop a like if you've stuck around to the end. It really helps more people see this video and grow the channel. Subscribe as well and hit the notification bell. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.